What's going on, you society? Hey, today we'll be playing a game where we'll have our two contestants here flinching, and we'll see who is the bigger punk today. You guys ready to play? I have my beautiful assistant, Amado, assisting us today. Go ahead and say hello to the people on camera.
No! Dang it! Okay, I flinched.
Can we get a beautiful hand for our assistant Amado? The results are in. We know who our loser is. You all right?
And three.
What's good, you society? How you doing? Listen, I don't know about you, but that was crazy, right? I wanna ask you guys a question. If you wanna be a part of some of our videos and you wanna say like, man, I wanna be in some of the videos, I wanna, you know, take a pie to the face or whatever the case would be, let us know. Hit us in the DM on IG or maybe even hit us in the comment section on YouTube, and we want you guys to be a part. We want your friends to like laugh with you. We want your friends to be like, man, I know them. So if you wanna be a part, don't hesitate. Hit us up. We want you guys to be a participant and be the leader that you were called to be, right? So we're just kind of finalizing some things with this last part of the series, right? Gratitude with attitude. Everybody say it with me. Gratitude with attitude. That's right. We understand that in this time, we're talking about gratitude, our heart posture to what we're trying to accomplish and what we want to do in life, right? But the thing that I want us to also acknowledge too, we also know is around this time, it could be a great time. We're looking forward to seeing cousins, our favorite cousin, our favorite aunt, our favorite uncle, or we're looking forward to seeing our favorite whoever, that family member that we look forward to seeing. But we also want to acknowledge this, that this could also be a tough time of the season. We know we've lost a lot of people in the past 2 years. And we can, whether it was a cousin, an aunt, or uncle, or even a parent. And we understand that it can be a difficult time in this time of season. And so as a youth society team, we want to extend this thing out to you and say, listen, if you need prayer, if you need somebody to talk to, if you're just like, hey, this is confusing to me, this is frustrating, and it just bothers me that like I can't have that favorite person or that person that was so close to me around this time, or this could be the first year that we're not going to have that person. Well, we want you to know, like, we're here to love you. We're here to, like, say, hey, if you just need an ear to listen, or if you're just like, hey, I need help with, like, I was reading this in the Bible, I need more understanding of this, don't hesitate to hit us up. or on our Wednesday nights or our Sunday mornings, go to your campus director and let them know, or some of the team, and let them know, like, listen, I need help, and this is tough for me. Christmas is coming, New Year's is coming, Thanksgiving is this week. I need somebody just to love me, man, and just recognize, like, who I am and what's going on in my life. And this kind of just goes into, like, what we're talking about today. And it comes out of Psalms 126. Psalms 126, 2 says this: then our mouth will be filled, everybody say filled, with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy. Everybody say joy. Then they said, among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. I'm going to pray, and we're going to jump right in. So, Father, we thank you and we praise you. We glorify you so much. Father, we thank you for just who you are. We ask that this word penetrates the hearts of those that are watching this online and those that will watch this in the future, that it may transform their mind and transform their heart, soul, and spirit. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, amen. So, in this time, they were going through a lot. But if you look up to verse one, it says that he was going to restore what they lost. He was going to restore what was going on in their life. And so I love how it says, then our mouths will be filled with laughter. And that was a time where depression was coming, a lot of heartache and pain was going on. But God is like, no, I'm going to fill you up with laughter. And my first point is this: your past embarrassments become your present joys. I'm gonna say that again. Your past embarrassments become your present joys. Like, I don't know about you, but I was just talking to Ray and some of the team about an embarrassing moment that I had, and it was like a super embarrassing moment, but now I can look back at it and be like, that was the dumbest thing in the world, right? But in the moment, you're embarrassed. In the moment, you just wanna go into like a little corner and die. And like in the moment, you're just like, oh my gosh, like why am I even here? I just wanna go home. I'll never forget this time. I went on a date with this girl, and I was like all excited, and I was like, man, she's so pretty. Oh man, like I'm trying to be swaggy, you know what I'm saying? Trying to be cool. But like, you know, your boy had a little bit of gas he got, you know what I'm saying? A little bit of woo, right? And I was like, you know, maybe I could just kind of slip it out when we're walking, and you know, the cool breeze, I just like kind of whoo past us, and she ain't gonna smell it. We gonna be good, right? And so I'm walking, we talk, I'm like, yeah, girl, you know what I'm saying? And like, I tried to slip, and it was like, I was like, and I, you know, like something happened, you try to just keep walking, and I literally walked, and I was like, man, what was that? That's crazy. And she looked at me like, boy, bye. Like, and I was like so embarrassed, but like, she kind of chuckled and, you know, whatever, but it was an embarrassing moment, because I'm trying, and I tried to cover it up like, oh, man, what was that? You step on something? Did I step on something? Like, and it was an embarrassing moment, but now it's something that I laugh about all the time. And whenever I tell that story, people just crack up. And being embarrassed is the worst feeling in the world, right? It's the worst. But it's a time that passes you, and you begin to think about what happened, and it becomes a great story to tell people. Like, I'm sure you guys have stories of like your cousin, of maybe you got tripped and fell and they fell into something, or you know, they did something embarrassing in front of like a cute boy or a cute girl, and you know, it was just something that's funny but embarrassing in the moment, but it makes for a great story later. Maybe you're embarrassed about some things that may have happened in your life, and you think that like, man, this is never gonna end. Let me tell you, it will end. It will be a great testimony to maybe help somebody, because they may be going through the exact same thing later in life. And God is just shaping and molding you to help that next person that may not know who Jesus is or may not know what joy is. And they're just like, man, thank you for telling me that story, because I thought that this was gonna last forever, or this was the worst thing that could ever happen. The next thing is this: your present joy is evidence of your past failures. Your present joy is evidence of your past failures. Just because things may not look great now doesn't mean God doesn't have a master plan for you in your life. I get it. Like right now, it seems like this pain may never end. It feels like this journey may never end. But let me help you understand something. where I'm at today, I thought I would never end up. I thought this thing was going to last forever. But now I'm in a place where I'm like, man, I thought that that was gonna last forever. But not realizing it's not gonna last forever. This is something that is gonna be like a crazy joy, a crazy story later in life. And our last point is this, because I want to get you guys over to your mac and cheese and your pumpkin pie, or for me, sweet potato pie, come on somebody, or maybe whatever your favorite dish is, I want you guys to go over to it. And your last point is this, your present joy is evidence of God's daily goodness. Your present joy is evidence of God's daily goodness. The world can point to all the negative things. The world is gonna tell you all these things that are absolutely outrageous. And I don't know about you, but there's times where I have to stop and like get off of social media because I feel myself getting riled up and getting angry. And I'm getting angry because I'm like, I don't like what I see. And so because of that, understand your joy, don't let anybody rob that joy from you. Don't let the world and Instagram and Snapchat and TikTok or whatever it is that robs your joy, don't let that happen. Because your present joy right now is evidence of God's daily goodness in your life. The air that you breathe, the heart that you have, the purpose that you're gonna walk in, the goals and the dreams and the visions in your life, like that is a daily reminder and evidence of God's daily goodness in your life. So don't let anybody and anything rob your joy. I want you guys to know this. The world has is negative all around us, but your joy will show that we have a good Father who still wants to bring laughter, he wants to bring healing, he wants to bring unity, and he wants to bring joy that will last for a lifetime. So listen, family. I pray that this encourages you today and you can walk away knowing that today is a daily reminder of God's, his evidence of his goodness in your life. He's so good, and I get it. It can be rough at times, but just know he loves you, he sees you, and he wants your heart. So I love you guys. Remember, you're loved, you're needed, and you're wanted. We can't wait to see you guys again in December. We'll have some dates coming out to you guys. We're excited. Have a phenomenal Thanksgiving. Eat all the turkey, ham, yams, and turkey. We got beans, greens, tomatoes, the potatoes. I don't know how it goes. But we know you're going to have a good time. Your belly will be full. And let your mouth be full of laughter today, tomorrow, and for the rest of your life. It's your boy. See you again, Youth Society. Peace.